Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. For today, we come to church to begin this season of Lent, with this first Sunday of Lent. And the first image that the church offers us for our contemplation is our Lord being led by the Holy Spirit into the desert to be tempted. And if the head of the body of Christ is being tempted, the same thing is going to happen to the body of Christ, which is the church and each one of us. And so temptation will always be part of our lives, no matter our age, our circumstances. Temptation will be something that we have to deal with until the end of our lives in this world. Now, about 10 years ago, a Christian magazine made a survey with their subscribers regarding the areas of their greatest spiritual challenges. The result showed that their greatest temptation was materialism. After materialism followed pride, self-centeredness, laziness, anger, lust, envy, gluttony, and finally, lying. Those who responded to the survey noted frequent temptations, for they were more frequent and more forceful when they had neglected their time with God. They stated that the ability to resist temptation was made easier by a strong spiritual life, avoiding compromising situations and being accountable to someone. Not every temptation is caused by Satan, but many of them. So we need to look at the two causes of temptation. Most temptations, many, are caused by our own tendency to sin. That means that we don't have complete control over our passions, our mind, our memory, our imagination, our emotions. Satan will always be the cause of many of our temptations. And Satan's greatest triumph is that he has caused many people to no longer believe that he really exists. But Satan is real, and his actions in the world are very real. So as the holy season of Lent begins this Sunday, the liturgy reminds us that we are engaged in a daily and dramatic battle between Christ and Satan, between good and evil. And what is at stake in this battle is our eternal salvation. Satan will do all that he can do to separate us from Christ. So the continual interior struggle to be faithful to God, to fulfill the commandment, to pray every day, will be of great personal benefit to each one of us. The struggle is like a workout, and every workout makes us stronger and allows us to go deeper. Although it is true that we will always be tempted, we must also do all we can do to avoid temptation. So, prayer, daily mass, adoration of the Blessed Sacrament and the frequent reception of confession are the proven remedies of temptation. At the same time, it is essential that we avoid the occasions of sin that put us in the danger not only of being tempted, but also may cause us to sin. The triple concupiscence of the world, the flesh, and the devil are just as real today as they have been over the entire history of humanity. Now, three questions. The first one, why are we tempted? Well, we are tempted all the time because we are proud. We don't guard our senses, especially our eyes, our ears. We don't have control over our passions, our natural impulses. The second question, why has the devil tempted us? Well, simply because he hates the image of God, which we bear in our soul. Because he is envious of man and wishes him to be in his own place. Because he seeks to make you his slave and companion of his designs. And so we have a lot to do because we cooperate with him in many different ways. In many different ways. Almost every day. In other words, we assist him in his evil designs against God. Two. Now, why is it that God allows us to be tempted? Well, first of all, because it is a good thing for us to be tempted. And for his greater glory. He wishes to know if we truly love him. And he also wants us to know ourselves. To keep our miseries in check. So he wishes to prove our virtue. To hold us in dependence on him. To prepare us for combat. To detach ourselves from creatures and to render us worthy of eternal life. So those are the reasons why we are being constantly tempted. So temptation is necessary and salutary for us because temptation makes us humble. Now there are two great remedies, very simple ones. Against temptations. The first one is humble prayer. Every day. Humble prayer. There is nothing more that the devil hates than simple prayer. Every day. The second thing is meditation on the passion of our Lord. If we are able to do these two things, we can be assured that we are going to have the grace that we need to overcome the temptations that come from the evil one. So Lent provides us with a special time of grace to examine our conscience and remove those things that are holding us back from a deeper fidelity to our Lord. Or may in fact be an obstacle to our eternal salvation. Let's take the time this Lent to find out what is it or in what ways we are easily tempted every day.